Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In this tutorial, we are going to insert font awesome icons and use them according to our project. Here they are, as we can see over here. All of these things, those are font awesome icons. So the whole procedure is very simple. First of all, we will be getting back to Google, and here we will be looking for font awesome. And in this particular case, the very first link in the search page, we will be right clicking it and open the link into the new tab. And there it goes, the official font awesome site. If we just come down below, we can see that free as in speech. Here you can see that declaration of font awesome, that font awesome is free, is still open source and completely free for commercial users. So the main objective of using font awesome is that we are using an open source. So that is why we will be needing to use this font awesome. So right now all we need to do, we need to go to download free and we will click on it and there it goes. Now the download procedure is complete. So we have downloaded this font awesome free 5.09.zip. In this respect, I would like to say that this is an upgraded version from font awesome and we are using this modified or updated version. So we have downloaded it off the internet. So all we need to do, we need to right click on it and we need to extract them here. And we can see that this is a folder of font awesome free 5.0.9. We can see that this is a folder with the name of web fonts with CSS and we'll be clicking into it. And this is the CSS file. All these CSS files, those are present inside. So we need to copy them and we need to get back to our project CSS folder. There it goes. If we just click in, we can see that all those CSS files, those are required to run our web page. Those are assembled over here. We need to paste them here. There it goes. And on the other hand, we need to get back to font awesome free folder again and we will be copying this thing from here, web fonts, and we will keep it outside of any folder but inside of root folder. So we are going to paste it. Here it is. Now this is the web fonts that has been placed outside of all those folders like CSS, fonts, images, etc. We need to get back to our project and here we will be now linking. We will have to link our fontawesome.all.min.css to our project. So that is why we are getting back to our project. And here this is the CSS and this is the file name. So we have to copy this file name from CSS folder. And all we are going to do, we are going to paste it here. Now it has been linked to our project. So let's get back to our project site, the part where we will be using that font awesome. And here, instead of this first paragraph, all we are now going to do, we are going to use this font awesome. So first of all, let's get back to font awesome official website. And here we will be clicking into this icons link here. There it goes. And here it comes. We can see that there's variety of icons, but first of all, we need to check this free link here. You can see that 989 awesome icons. So we are clicking onto this first icon. So this is the first icon and this is the syntax used for this particular icon here. So all we now need to do, we need to copy this code and we will be pasting it here. Now let's get back to our project and check whether these font awesome icons are working properly or not. Yes, it is working. We can see that the font awesome icon is now present here. Now before proceeding to our next project, first of all, if we get back to our project, we can see that we have missed this particular heading known as operating process. So this is what we need to do. We need to rectify in the first place.